The Yuba Water Agency is highlighting how teamwork is leading an effort to protect thousands of homes and water from future catastrophic fires.
KCRA 3's Mike Tissell is joining us live in Marysville to detail why water managers say teamwork is needed to address the worsening issue of wildfires.
Yeah, and you know, the manager here at the Yuba Water Agency saying that, quite frankly, they're lucky that their reservoir hasn't been impacted yet by fire. Take a look. What we're talking about is New Bullard's Bar and the powerhouse just downstream of it. Since May, the Yuba Water Agency has been using a $4.5 million Cal Fire grant to actively thin and reduce overgrowth in a 71,000 acre zone of forest that includes more than 2,700 homes. It's also the same area that is just south of where those recent fires have been burning in Butte County and parts of Yuba County. Water officials say this is not about clear-cutting the forest. Instead, it's a vision and a hope that by partnering with other agencies like Cal Fire, the Forest Service, and environmental groups, team efforts like this can create a more sustainable forest where wildfire can burn without catastrophic results.
And our forests really aren't sustainable in the condition they're in because, you know, every acre in the Sierra Nevada is prone to fire. And, you know, if a fire starts, we're seeing the results. It's not burning lightly or moderately. We're having these catastrophic events.
Now, the Yuba Water Agency cautions this is not an overnight fix. They say it took 150 to 200 years to get the forest to a state where it's overgrown and prone to these catastrophic wildfires. So they say it's going to take time to get the forest back to a healthy state. But they say teamwork like this, collaborative efforts among agencies that may have differing views, that is something that's going to be key to addressing this ongoing issue of catastrophic wildfire in California in the future. Live in Yuba City, in Marysville, in Yuba County this morning, Mike Tissell, KCRA 3 News.
All right, Mike, thanks so much for that.